When you have to answer question of this type, we have two approaches for answering. The first is, let us assume that the maximum marks are X. When he gets 30%, it means he gets X into 30 by 100 and he failed by 10 marks. Means when we add 10 here, that is the passing marks. In the second case, he gets 35% of the marks, X into 35 by 100, he gets 5 marks more than the passing marks. If I subtract 5 here, he will be just pass. So this is passing marks and this is passing marks. We can make a comparison between these two and we can answer it. 5 will come here, 15, this will come here and subtract 5x upon 100, x equals to 300. So we can say the maximum marks of the paper will be 300. We have to find the passing percentage and passing marks, that is the passing marks. Put x equal to 300, 90 plus 10, passing marks are equal to 100. And if you have to find passing percentages out of 300 by passing marks of 100, I can say this is equal to 33.33%. So that's the first method, that is known as equation method. We can also answer this question by small structure. Means when he gets 30% of the marks, he is failed by 10 marks. Means that he gets 10 marks less. In the second case, when he gets 35% of the marks, he gets 5 marks more. What is the difference in the percentage? 5%. What is the difference in absolute value? First he was 10 marks less, now he is 5 marks more. It means this is equal to 15. So we can say 5% would be taken as 15. We have to find the maximum marks, this is 100%. 100% is taken as 300. We can say the maximum marks is 300. That is the value of x that we have found by using this equation, or we can directly answer it by such way. The maximum marks is 300, then we can find our passing marks as well as we can find the passing percentage. I hope the idea is clear to you. We can take one more example in order to better understand this concept. If price of mango decreases by 20%, it enables the buyer to buy 10 mangoes more for rupees 100. We have to find what is the initial price per mango. Question is, what is the initial price per mango? Now have a look over this question. The price of mango decreases by 20%. It enables a buyer to buy 10 mangoes more for rupees 100. Based on this, we have to find what is the initial price of the mango. We have two types of approaches in order to answer this question. Suppose initial price was X. It was decreased by 20%. It means it has become 4 by 5X. That my initial price, that is my decreased price. In the first case, we spent rupees 100 and my initial price was X per mango. So this is number of mangoes, this is the total expenditure, this is price per mango. When I divide 100 by X, I get total number of mangoes. In the second case, I have to spend rupees 100 and the decreased price is 4 by 5X. So that is my number of mangoes when the price was X. That is the number of mangoes this quantity is 10 more than this one. So if I subtract 10 here, both are equal. And after solving this equation, we have to find x. So we have to solve it. 4 will go to 25, 5 will come outside. We can take it as 100 by x equal to 125 by x minus 10. Or I can say 25 by x equal to 10 or x equal to rupees 2.5. So we can say the price per mango is rupees 2.5. We may have a different approach for answering this question. The price decreases by 20%. It means the number of mangoes that we buy in 100 rupees earlier, now for the same quantity we have to spend rupees 80. Earlier, if we spend rupees 100 in buying some mangoes, now for getting the same quantity we have to spend rupees 80. What is the change in money? 20 rupees. And because of that change, we are in a position to buy 10 mangoes more. It means we can say that the decreased price of the mango is equal to rupees 2 per mango. The decreased price of the mango is rupees 2 per mango, right? And this 4 by 5x, that is the decreased price. I have to find initial price. So I can say 4 by 5x was decreased price, this is equal to 2. My initial price will become 2.5 rupees. That becomes my answer. Just try to understand it again. Suppose earlier you have to spend rupees 100. After a decrease of 20%, now for buying the same quantity, you have to spend rupees 80. It means how much money you are spending less? 20. And in this 20 rupees, you are getting initial, you are getting additional 10 more mangoes. So we can say one mango costs rupees 2, but that 2 rupees is the decreased price of the mango. But in the question, we are expected to find the initial price. So we can say 4 by 5x equal to 2, x will be equal to rupees 2.5. That becomes our answer. I hope the concept is clear. Next, we have questions based on expenditures and income. Expenditures and income. As we know that income minus expenditure is equal to savings. We know that income minus expenditure is equal to saving. For example, if I say if ratio of income is to expenditure is 3:2. The ratio of income and expenditure of a person is 3:2. That is said to that in the next year, income increases by 20%. And expenditure decreases by 30%. So we have to find out what is the percentage change in savings. What the question is, it is given that income increases by 20%, expenditure decreases by 30%. We have to find percentage change in savings. When we look over this question, everywhere we are using percentage, no absolute value is involved. It simply means when we have to answer this question, so we will assume the income and expenditure to be 3:2. So I can say my savings is equal to 1. Income is 3 and expenditure is 2. So I can say the savings is equal to 1. Next year, income increases by 20%. So we know that 20% of 3 is 0.6. So my income becomes 3.6. Expenditure decreases by 30%. 30% 2 is also 0.6, but that is decreased. So I can say my expenditure is 1.5. 4. Now my 7 becomes 2.2. I have to find the ratio. The 1 ratio 2.2. The 1 is 2. 22 by 10. So we can say 10 ratio 22 or answer is 5 ratio 11. That becomes our answer. So we can see that the ratio of income and expenditure, we can say that the ratio of savings is 5 ratio 11. If we have to find the ratio of the saving, that becomes 5 ratio 11. On the other hand, in this question, we have to find percentage change in savings. So I can say, what is the change? 1.2. My original value was 1 into 100. The answer is said to be percentage change is 120%. That becomes our answer. Right? Now we have two standard formulas. Number of questions are asked over this. Although these questions you can answer with the earlier concept that I have explained you, the 6 questions. But in number of places these standard shortcut formulas are also used. For example, it is given that A is 20% more than B. You have to answer B is how much percent less than A. It is given that if A is 20% more than B, you have to answer B is how much percent less than A. So one approach you can apply, suppose B is 100, A become 120, then B is how much percent less than A. How much is less? 20. From which it is less? A. 120 into 100. The answer is said to be 16.66% less. That's your answer. Or we have a standard formula. If in any question it is given that A is R percent more than B. A is R percent more than B. And we have to answer B is how much percentage less than A. So we can directly answer it, R divide by 100 plus R into 100. What we can apply? R upon 100 plus R into 100. This is 20%. So we can take it as 20 upon 120 into 100. Answer is equal to 16.66%. Right? Similarly, if instead of increase, decrease is given. A is 20% less than B. We have to find out B is how much percent more than A. Right? So for that, we can take it as if it is R percent less than B, B is how much percentage more than A. You can directly apply R upon 100 minus R into 100. You can use this formula. Or in the similar way, you can assume B to be 100, A becomes 80. B is how much percentage more than A? 20. From which you are comparing with A into 100. The answer is equal to 25%. Or if you put R equal to 20 here, you will get the same value, that is equal to 25%, right? So that is a standard concept in which we use these two formulas. First one is R divided by 100 plus R into 100. And the second one is R upon 100 minus R into 100. Now, after this, we have the next point, point number 6. The concept is known as successive percentage change and its application. Just try to understand it and then we will answer it. For example, one number is given as 100. It is given that first it is increased by 20%, then it is further increased by 30%. This is one number A. First it is increased by 20%, then it is further increased by 30%. Two increases are given. We have to find out what is the total percentage increase, a total percentage change. Right? The first approach states take 100, find the value 120 upon 100 into 130 upon 100. When you solve it, you find it as 156. Means earlier your number was 100 and now it becomes 156. What is the overall percentage change? 56%. So your answer becomes equal to 56%. Have you got the idea? And you will be surprised to know if instead of 100, if there is 200 and first it increases by 20%, then it increases by 30%. And you have to find what is the total percentage change. What you will do, you find the number in the similar way, 200 into 120 upon 100 into 130 upon 100. This becomes equal to 312. From 202 it becomes equal to 312 and the percentage change is equal to 56%. That simply states us that value does not matter, either it is 100 or 200 or it may be X or Y. If the percentage increase or decrease is given to you same, the overall percentage change would be same. So we have a very standard shortcut formula. Whenever we have to find the percentage change, this formula is taken as A plus B plus A into B divided by 100. A plus B plus A into B divided by 100. If at any place there is a decrease, we take it as negative. If there is a decrease, we take it as a negative value. For example, A first increased by 20%, then increased by 30%. We have to find the overall percentage increase. The answer is 20 plus 30 plus 20 into 30 divided by 100. 20 plus 30 is 50 plus 6. Answer is equal to 56%. It becomes the answer. Just have a look over this formula. This formula is used when a number is successively changed by few percentages. In that case, you can apply this formula A plus B plus AB divided by 100. If there is an increase, sign to be positive. If there is a decrease, sign to be negative. So in this question, we have 20% increase, then we have 30% increase. We can say 20 plus 30 plus 20 into 30 divided 100, 50 plus 6, answer is said to be 56%. We try to understand this concept with some more examples. Suppose there is a number A, first it has to be increased by 30%, then decreased by 20%. First there is an increase. Above arrow symbol increase and down arrow symbol is decrease. So you have to find out what is the overall percentage change. So if we directly apply this formula, 30 decrease, it should be negative, minus 20, then plus AB. This is positive, this is negative, this becomes negative. 20 into 30 divided by 100, this would be taken as 10 minus 6, 4. It is positive, so we can say 4% increase. Understand one more question. There is a number A. First it decreases by 30%. Then it further decreases by 20%. You have to find out what is the overall percentage change. In this question, at both places we are taking as decrease. So we take it as minus 30 minus 20, and now two negative values will be multiplied, it becomes positive. 20 into 30 divided by 100, so this will be taken as minus 50 plus 6 minus 44. We can say there is a decrease of 44%. The answer is 44% decrease. I think the idea is clear. These questions that we have understood, in these questions we are taking two successive percentage change, either increase or decrease, or one increase or one decrease. Now sometime you will find the percentages changes are more than two, that are three. For example, there is a one number A, first it increases by 20%, then it decreases by 30%, then it further increases by 10%. We have to find out what is the overall percentage change. Now if we want to apply this formula, we have two approaches here. The first approach states, combine these two by the formula 20 minus 30 minus 20 into 30 upon 100. So I can say minus 10 minus 6 minus 16. Now combine this 10 with this minus 16. With the same formula, so you will make it as minus 16, it was increased, plus 10 minus 16 into 10 divided by 100. So we can say minus 6 minus 1.6 minus 7.6. So answer is 7.6% decrease. That's your answer. What we have understood means, in a number, if there is a percentage change for more than once, it may be thrice, it may be four times, so we solve it step by step. First we take these two values, answer is minus 16, means there is 16% decrease. Then we take this 10%, it means 10% increase, we take it as minus 16 plus 10, minus 16 into 10 by 100, we can solve it, 7.6% decrease. Or we have a standard formula here, means A% change, then B% change, then C% change. Means in a number, if three successive percentages are changed, we can use this formula A plus B plus C plus AB plus BC plus CA upon 100 plus ABC upon 10,000. You have to just put your values. If there is an increase, put the plus sign. If there is a decrease, put the negative sign. And at least you can find out what is the overall percentage change. Sometime it is given to you that, means there is a number A, first it increases by 20%, then it decreases by 20%. There is a number A, first it increases by 20%, then it decreases by 20%, and the question is, what is the percentage change? So we can apply this 20 minus 20 minus 20 into 20 upon 100. So I can say minus 4, it means there is a decrease of 4% decrease. Don't answer it 0%. We cannot say it. Why? Because first 20 minus 20 minus 20 into 20 by 100, we are getting minus 4, that is 4% decrease. Now, the important part is, we have to understand the application part of this. That is an understanding about the concept of successive percentage change. But we have to understand the application part. Just try to understand here. You will know that area of a rectangle. We can say that area of a rectangle is always equal to length into breadth. If it is given that length of the rectangle increases by 20%, and breadth of the rectangle increases by 30%. Suppose one rectangle is given, length of the rectangle increases by 20% and breadth of the rectangle increases by 30%. You have to find out what is the overall percentage change in area. We have to find out what is the percentage change in area. If you have to answer this question, some approaches you can apply. You can assume your length to be 100 and breadth to be 100. So area would be taken as 10,000, or you can take it as x and y. Area would be taken as x into y. Then it states you length increases by 20%. It becomes 120, breadth becomes 130, new area becomes 15600. Or when you go with x and y, so this becomes 1.2x, this becomes 1.3y, and overall area becomes 1.56xy. Right? We have to find out percentage change. Here my area becomes from 10,000 to 15,600. Percentage change is equal to 5600 divided by 10,000 into 100. Answer is equal to 56%. In this case, we can say it was xy and now it had become 1.56xy. What is the change? 0.56xy upon xy into 100. Our answer is equal to 56%. Right? But if we just look at this question, we can also apply the concept of successive percentage here. How? This increased by 20%, this by 30%. We have to find overall percentage change. Maybe 20 plus 30 plus 20 into 30 upon 100. You will get it as 56%. So what concept we can infer from this question, and then we try to apply that concept over some other type of questions. Just try to understand this. What the concept talks about? Suppose some parameters are multiplied. That may be length into breadth, area, or we can take area of a square, side into side. If first increases by first percentage changes a percent, in the second percentage changes b percent, or there will be a third part, it is c percent. So if you have to find overall percentage change in a, you have to find what is the overall percentage change. For finding the overall percentage change, you can apply the same formula, a plus b plus ab divided by 100. Right? For example, if I say if sine of a square increases by 30%, sine of a square increases by 30%, I have to find what is percentage increase in area. Now what I can say, square area is side into side, means this is 30%, this is 30% increased. So we have to find the overall percentage change. So what we will apply? 30 plus 30 plus 30 into 30 upon 100. 60 plus 9. Answer is equal to 69%. I think got the idea? 30 plus 30 plus 30 into 30 by 100. Why we have taken it? Because area is side into side. If multiplication is there, in that case, you can apply the concept of successive percentage change. So I am going to explain some more methods. Yeah, I am going to explain some more areas where you use it. Area of a circle, pi into r, pi is constant, it does not affect. So suppose if I say radius increases by 20%, this by 20, this by 20, overall percentage change would be 20 plus 20 plus 20 into 20 upon 100. So we can say our answer is equal to 44%. Volume of a cube, that is A into A into A, volume of a cuboid, length into breadth into height, or we can say expenditure is equal to price into quantity purchased into number of tickets sold. Means that any place where two or more quantities are multiplied and percentage change in those quantities are given, and we have to find the overall percentage change. At all these questions we use this approach, A plus B plus AB by 100. If there is increase, take the sign to be positive, as I stated you earlier, and if there is a decrease, make the sign negative and just answer your question. There is one more application of this. For example, if I say, if length of rectangle increases by 20% but area remains same, find percentage change in breadth. What is given to you? If length of a rectangle increases by 20% but area remains the same, we have to find out what is the percentage change in breadth. We know that area equal to L into B, length increases by 20%, area remains same. Same means change in area is 0%. We will assume that change in breadth is X percent. So I can apply this, 0 equal to 20 plus x plus 20 into x divide 100. This would be minus 20 equal to 6x by 5. And when you solve it, x is equal to minus 100 upon 6, or we can say minus 16.66%, or there is a decrease of 16.66%. That becomes your answer. How you can answer it? Assume length and breadth, area is this. It is given that length increased by 20%. So I can say this is 20% increase, positive. Area remains same, means no change in area, 0%. I have to find percentage change in breadth. I will simply take it as 1. If in the last I will get a positive value, it means it is increased. If I get a negative value, it means it is increased. What we have done, we have just solved it, and in the last I got it x equal to minus 16.66%, it means there is a decrease of 16.66%. Here we can use one standard formula also that we have earlier used in a question. When two or more quantities are multiplied, if any quantity increased by R percent, meaning that should be increased, and total must remain same, means no change, and we have to find out percentage change in third one, that is in breadth, so that everyone can understand. If it is increased, total remains the same, it means it must be decreased, and by what percentage it is decreased, this is equal to R upon 100 plus R into 100. So this question, what you can say, length increases by 20%, so you can apply this, you can say 20 upon 120 into 100, this will give you, there is a decrease of 16.66%, means nothing have to be applied, you can just directly put this formula and you can answer it. Similarly, if in place of increase, if it is given that there is decrease of 20% or there is decrease of R percent, overall will remain same. That means third quantity will increase and you have to find what is the percentage increase. Your formula will be changed. Here in the place of plus R you have to make it minus R. It should be R divided by 100 minus R into 100. That becomes your answer. So what you can say in this question, it is given that length decreases by 20%. So you make it as 20 upon 80 into 100, 1 by 4. The answer is said to be 25%. So you can say your breadth must increase by 20% so that the total area will remain the same. So these two formulas are quite important for you, that you already know. In earlier questions also we have used it. R upon 100 plus R into 100 means when increase is given, you have to find the decrease. On the other hand, when decrease is given and you have to find the increase, you apply this formula R divided by 100 minus R into 100. We may have a look over one more question. That's a very standard statement. If price of kerosene oil increases by 20%, price of kerosene oil increases by 20%, by what percentage consumption should be decreased? By what percentage consumption should be decreased so that overall expenditure remains the same? So that overall expenditure remains same. That's our question. It means, what we can think of price into consumption, that is always equal to total expenditure. It is given that price increases by 20%, it is increased 20%, overall expenditure means remains same, means no change. So you have to find percentage change in consumption. Just apply direct formula R upon 100 plus R into 100 and just put here 20 upon 120 into 100 and you will find your answer is 16.66% decrease. That becomes your answer. I hope the concept is clear to you now. This concept is known as percentage change. This concept can be applied whenever some numbers are multiplied, generally 2 or it may be 3, and you have to find overall percentage change or you have to find percentage change in any of the quantity. So by applying this formula, you can find out what is the percentage change. Now we are being left with one or two more points in this topic of percentages. In this we use a term that is known as percentage points. We use a term which is known as percentage point. Percentage point is an absolute quantity. Percentage point is absolute quantity. Have a look over this. Suppose 20% is a number. Suppose one quantity is 20%. We have to make an increase of 10% in it. 10% increase. So what I am going to do, I will make it. First I will find out 10% of 20%. This will be 2%. And my overall increase would be 2. Answer is 20. Answer will be 12%. Suppose my number is 20%. Sorry, it would be 22%. Why? Because it is 20%. My percentage is 20%, I have to make increase of 10%, so I will just find out 10% of 20, 2%, 20 plus 2, answer is 22%. But on the other hand, if it is given that number is 20%, it is increased by 10 percentage points. It is increased by 10 percent point, then it becomes equal to 30%. Why? Because percent point is an absolute quantity. So in any question, wherever there is named as percentage point increase, make it plus. If there is stated as percentage point decrease, you have to make it minus. I think the point is clear now. In any question, when we say percentage point, it means we have to directly add it, increase in the case of increase. In the case of decrease, we have to directly subtract it. Otherwise, we just find a percentage and add as per to the addition. And if there is a decrease, we will subtract. Sometimes we use the term appreciation or depreciation. Appreciation means increase. Or depreciation means decrease. For example, it is given that a machine was purchased 4 rupees 5 lakh. Every year value decreases by, yeah, value depreciated by 20%. We have to find what will be the value of the machine after 3 years. We have to find what will be the value of the machines after 3 years. That simply means depreciated means decrease. So I will make it as 5 lakh for the first year, 100 minus 20 upon 100. For the second year also, 100 minus 20 upon 100. For the third year also, 100 minus 20 upon 100. What we can say now, 5 into 80 upon 100 into 80 upon 100 into 80 upon 100. After solving this, we can make it as 4 by 5. This would be 4 by 5. This would be 4 by 5. That will be cancelled out. So would be taken as 64 divided by 25. I can easily solve it. 25 will go on 2, that will be 50. Then we have the remainder is 14. Then I will take 0.140. 25 will go on 5, 125, then 6. So I can say value of the machine would be 2.56 lakhs after 3 years. On the other hand, if in case of if it is in the case of depreciated, if it is appreciated. If it is appreciated, then where we have made 100 minus 20 by 80, so we will make it as 100 plus 20 by 80 means 120 by 100 into 120 by 100 into 120 by 100, and after solving this, we get our answer. I think the point is clear to you now. What is the meaning of appreciation? It means increase, and what is the meaning of depreciation? It means decrease. Right? So this is a complete concept about percentages. After understanding of this, you can try with the questions. When you solve it, before solving the questions, first of all, you must have a look about these concepts so that you are in a position to answer accurately. Thank you very much.